Hello to everybody. It's been a very long time, and I hope all of you are doing good across the globe. People in Asia, Europe, Americas, in Australia, wherever you are watching this video from, my hello to all of you. Today, the topic that I'm going to choose is network slicing. But before we go into the details of this topic, I want to tell you a very important thing. 5G is at the crossroad right now in terms of its further deployments and in terms of the value the CSPs can get out of it. And one of the key things right now is how to monetize a 5G. A lot of deployments have happened across the globe. For example, massive deployments in India, across the US, across Australia, and also in the Southeast Asia, Japan, Tokyo, all of these places. But the biggest question right now for all the people in the industry is how to monetize these investments, how we can create those use cases which 5G offers us, and how we can synergize the advancements which 5G offers us towards real life use cases. And network slicing is one of the very important pillars that 5G offers in that regard. In order to explain network slicing, I will give an example that from a different industry. For example, you go to a bank and the bank offers you a number of services. It can offer you a car loan, it can offer you a home loan, it can offer you other financing opportunities. It has enterprise customers where it gives credit line to the companies, and so on and so forth. But when you compare it to the CSP business model as of now for 4G and 5G services, it's more or less mobile broadband, or in some cases it's fixed wireless access. Other than that, the market of CSPs is kind of limited. And the kind of, you can say, funnel in terms of the opportunities CSPs have to make money out of their networks is pretty limited. And if that's why, if you see the revenue growth of these CSPs over the years, it's not even in double digits. So where does network slicing come into being? The concept of network slicing goes to the concept of service differentiation. How do you differentiate services and how you offer different services to different segments of the market? And network slicing is like making the network into different slices and then offering those slices to different segments of the market. For example, you can have a network slice for your enterprise customers. You can have a network slice for your mobile broadband customers. You can have a network slice for your on-premises, industrial sectors, and so on and so forth. But how does it work? How does network slicing bring that service differentiation into your network? I will look into the architecture a bit, and then also how this architecture works in conjunction with all the elements of the network to bring about that value in that service differentiation. First of all, the most important point, network slicing is only available on 5G standalone. So if you have deployed your network in a non-standalone mode, 5G slicing, network slicing is not going to work because it requires your 5G core network. And the basic definition of a slice is done on the core side, and then all of those functions are translated into the RAN domain and the other domains. So what is actually network slicing in terms of the 3GP specifications? So the one of the most important, you can say, word in terms of slicing, which we might heard, is this one, SNSSAI. This is your single network slice selection association identifier. What it does is that it gives you an identifying number or a code or something like that, which I will explain further, that your UE is assigned to in your core network. What does this number consist of is an SST and then an ST. This is your slice or service type, and this is your service differentiator. In terms of 3GPP specifications, let's go back to the concept of service differentiation. This SST is defined for your ultra reliable low latency communication. It is defined for your mobile broadband. It is defined for your massive IoT. It is defined for your vehicle layer communication, and so on. And all of these SSTs are numbered like this. This is, I think, one. This is one. This is one. This is three. This is four, and so on. And then within these SSTs, so for example, you have one of this EMBB. This can have multiple service differentiators. So you can have multiple slices within this EMBB. So the basic format of that slice will be EMBB, and you can make different slices out of these. So you can give service differentiation to your EMBB customers, and then on a network level, you can give service differentiators to your rest of these use cases. And of course, CSPs will charge different amount of money for all of these cases. This is one thing. And then this is configured on your core side. So that is called your configured SNSSAI. And this is also then subscribed on your UESIM as well. So when your UE sends out the messages to your core in your registration, it will send out this identifier, and then your core will select the required slice it wants to give to. The second thing, which is more important, is that how do you configure these slices? How do you provide that service differentiation? And I will give you a bit of an idea in this, and we will carry on this discussion on network slicing, because this is a huge topic. So we will discuss in our lectures how we select a particular slice and so on and so forth. But for now, let's see how we do it in the RAN and core side. So this is your network. So this is your core, this is your transport, and this is your RAN. So based on this SST and SD, you will have a different set of configuration. So for example, you have slice 1, slice 2, slice 3, and so forth. The same will happen here, and the same will happen here. So what will happen is that, for example, your UE is on slice 1. So it will have a certain set of resources, and how those resources are allocated, that I'll go on the RAN side. So whenever a UE comes and it belongs to your slice 1, then it will be treated as a particular way on your RAN side. Then it will be treated in a particular way on your transport side, and then it will be dealt in a particular way on your core side. So what differences can we have on the RAN side? For example, we will have a certain number of resources allocated to S1. So for example, we are in a stadium and we have offered premium services for our influencers, our Instagrammers, our generation, which is very likely to stream whatever is happening to this S1. So they buy those premium services, and then these users will have certain number of resources sanctioned for them. And even if they have a congestion situation in the stadium, these UEs will have those particular resources sanctioned for them, and they will not be facing any network disruptions or network congestion. And because of that premium service, they will be able to still have acceptable throughput. Other thing which, for example, can be on the core side is that for particular services, for example, you have latency services. I will give an example of a remote surgery. Of course, if you're performing a remote surgery, a latency of 100 milliseconds or 200 milliseconds will not be enough. So you will have to bring that down to 10 milliseconds, 5 milliseconds, or even in the range of 1 milliseconds. To do that, you have to put your UPF closer to your UE. So for example, for a particular slice which serves UEs in that application, you will have that core entity placed closer to your end user, and that will be your slice configuration. So that is how these things work in different network domains, and that's how they provide those differentiated services. Just as I give an example, in one service it's avoiding congestion, in the other service it's providing you high latency. And this is where the CSPs will have to work with this very powerful technology of network slicing to bring together those use cases. And I believe that network slicing will be a very key element as we move towards the monetization of 5G. And this is the key concept of service differentiation, where we can provide differentiated experience, and then of course the CSPs can charge for that differentiated experience. Also, this will make the ecosystem of telecom go into the world of enterprise, other industries, automation, vehicular communication, all sorts of industries. And this is what the goal should be, that the ecosystem becomes larger and so that the revenues can grow further and all of us can see the real benefits of 5G across the globe. So thank you so much for your time today. And if you have any questions, please post it in the comment section. Please subscribe to the channel. I'm very thankful for all the comments and all the positive feedback. And if you have any further questions, my LinkedIn data is given in the description of the video, and you can send me messages on that. And also, if you want to have a detailed session of network slicing, please let me know. So thank you so much. See you next time.